Let's begin with breaking news at 8 a.m. on Australia's vaccine rollout with a fourth dose now approved. Straight to Nine's Chris O'Keefe, who is in Sydney. Chris, good morning. Who recommended this?
It was Atagi, Charles. The nation's vaccine task force, they've told the federal government that a fourth COVID vaccine dose is recommended and is necessary for all Australians over the age of 65. Now, the timing of this is interesting. Basically, what Atagi is telling the federal government is this should be the winter dose. So since your booster shot or your third shot, wait 4 months and then get your fourth dose if you are over the age of 65. Now, for people, Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander people, that is the age of 50, and all residents who are in disability care or nursing homes should also get this fourth dose. Now, the reasoning for this is with waning immunity, and what we're seeing basically is the start of a winter wave of COVID all around Australia. And with the third dose now starting to wane a bit, the immunity from that, the question that Atagi and the federal government are asking themselves is how to best protect the vulnerable, the people in Australia who are most vulnerable to severe illness from COVID, and that is our elderly populations and those populations in those vulnerable settings like nursing homes. So a fourth dose 4 months after your booster shot if you are over the age of 65. Charles?
A big change in this ongoing fight, Chris. Thank you. In another boost in our fight against the virus, two Melbourne-made COVID-19 jabs are about to be given patient trials. Dubbed super vaccines, developed by the Doherty Institute and Monash University, it hopes to provide a more targeted immunity to COVID.
Another protester is disrupting freight trains in Sydney this morning for a fourth day of demonstrations. Police are now on the scene at Tempe, where the demonstrator has suspended themselves from the rail bridge over a canal. Earlier, they uploaded a live video to Blockade Australia's Facebook. Multiple explosions and billowing smoke have shattered the peace at a suburban street in Queensland. Jessica Millwood is at the scene in Kingston. Jess, police have spent the night searching the area.
They have, Layla. Their investigation is still very much ongoing this morning after this improvised explosive device detonated at this Kingston home last night. Police say that a 52-year-old was handling what is believed to have been a bucket bomb full of nails when it exploded. I'm joined now by Sam. He is a nearby resident here. Sam, you heard a couple of explosions. Describe to me exactly what you saw here last night.
Exactly around 5:26 last night. I was inside the house. I'm just a couple of houses up on the other side. So the first explosion I heard, it was a big loud sound, and then after that we came out. We stood here and we were talking to the neighbours here, Michael. So, yeah, and then after maybe 3, 4, 5 minutes, and then the second explosion, it was very loud, so we just ran away. We ran on the other side of the corner there.
Yeah. And scary stuff for you here.
Yeah. Very scary. Yeah. Yeah, it was really loud. So there was a couple of kids out here, so they just like, we all ran, and then, so the lady came out. The police car was coming from that end of the road, and then she waved to the police car and stopped them. And after that, like, there was, like, lots of police cars around here, and they just blocked the road.
Sam, thank you for your time. I really do appreciate it. Layla, a 52-year-old man is this morning in hospital. Police obviously very keen to speak to him.
OK, Jess, thank you.
Sydney commuters will dodge major disruptions on the train network today after the union and state government came to an agreement. Gabrielle Boyle is at Parramatta train station. Gabby, good morning to you. Commuters are being offered free trips by way of an apology for the recent headaches.
They certainly are, Alex. It's a bit of a silver lining. Plenty of Sydney-siders have found themselves standing on train station platforms waiting for trains that were either delayed or completely cancelled. It's been a frustrating few weeks for Sydney commuters, but now a silver lining. We're being told that the Transport Minister, David Elliott, and the Rail, Tram and Bus Union have come to an agreement, and we will get a fee-free day, a day where commuters can ride free. But we haven't got the details yet. We don't know what date this will be on, and we don't know who will be eligible, but no doubt we'll find out the details over the coming days. We are being warned if we're heading out and about on Sydney trains trains, however, that there could be some delays in the next few days as track work continues following the recent floods. Alex?
Gabby, thanks so much. Ukrainian forces have bombed a Russian warship. Footage shows smoke billowing from the vessel, which was parked in the port of Berdyansk in southeast Ukraine. It's understood that the attack occurred after the location was revealed in a propaganda video. Russia's been using the port to ferry in equipment for its troops. A kangaroo on the loose in this part of the world is pretty normal, but in the US, hey? A Michigan woman captured the Australian native jumping on her driveway. Unsure of what to do? Somebody call 911. That's exactly what she did. And even the dispatcher didn't believe her. Well, it turns out it was a pet named Douglas. And he just got out from his enclosure. Now she's trying to convince her family to get one themselves. Poor old Doug.
Doug's very lost.
But look at it.
Very lost. He's in the wrong country for a start.
Exactly. Wrong continent.
Wrong
got it all going on.
Wrong part of the world altogether. Anyway, TJ's in the right place. He's in Melbourne with sport. G'day.
Thanks, Alex. I tell you what, a hell of a hop, wasn't it, from Queensland all the way across the ocean there. So well done to Dougie and his mates. Hey, I want to talk about the AFL first up because Marvel Stadium last night, Carlton continue to go ahead in leaps and bounds, if I can say that. They defeated the Western Bulldogs. They did it without their coach, Michael Voss, who was home with COVID, but he was still phoning in advice after each quarter there. Also, a couple of players were out with COVID. Sam Walsh was back, his first game since surgery only 40 days ago. Charlie Curnow kicked 5 goals and Patrick Cripps, the captain, was unbelievable. Here's just a couple of highlights here. 2 goals was the margin in the end. And as I said, Carlton made it 2 from 2 now in what is one of their best starts for well over a decade. A flurry of goals brought home the win for Carlton, putting them on top of the premiership ladder. Don't get that excited, though.
It was just a fantastic opportunity to continue to embed our identity and how we want to play. And there's no better test than when you're playing a really good side.
Meanwhile, Buddy Franklin is eyeing his 1,000th career goal tonight against Geelong in Sydney. So the NRL and the Cronulla Sharks are certainly shaping up as a formidable force this season, thrashing their local rivals St George Illawarra. 36-12, that scoreline. A swathe of stars piled on the points for Cronulla with new recruit Nico Hynes. Nico Hynes bagging 16 points. Meanwhile, the Roosters and the Rabbitohs cannot wait for this one tonight. They play in Sydney. You can catch all the action for that particular clash. And isn't there some spite when these two play? That's on 9 tonight. Just check your local guides. And in cricket, Australia will take on Pakistan on the last day of the third test in Lahore. The Aussies, boy, do they need some quick wickets as they try to clinch the series. But that NRL match tonight, the Roosters and the Rabbitohs, as I say, traditional foes. And Layla, I know you're a Roosters household. It's going to be a very nervy night
it
in
is.
Your household tonight.
Yeah, and the fishmonger is a Rabbitoh. I can't buy fish if the Rabbitohs win, so I've got a lot riding on this.
Not the fishmonger.
I know.
The fishmonger, no.
Freckle, he's got his priorities all wrong there. Thanks very much for that. Let's go to the weather now with Tim, who's recovering from that wild ride.
Yes, your designated survivor just survived. I actually got stuck in it, truth be told. I'm a little bit too big for some of the rides here. I'm a big kid at heart, so I'll give anything a go. The tornado, though, I'm going to give this a go in half an hour. We're just gearing up, but I wanted to see how it kind of works. I'm pretty sure they're squeals of delight. At least I'm hoping they are. They're waving, they're smiling, they're having fun. That is going to be me in half an hour. Before I do that, though, I need a bit of a pep talk from some experts here at Wet and Wild on the Gold Coast. I'll do that right after we take a look at your forecast today. Cairns, good morning to you. You're heading for a partly cloudy top today of 31 degrees. Brisbane, partly cloudy as well in 29. For Sydney, some showers around. Canberra, a shower or two for you as well, partly cloudy for Melbourne and for Hobart. Adelaide, mostly sunny today in 24. Perth, mostly sunny for you. A top of 36 degrees, 31 for the Alice and looking fine. And Darwin, a possible shower or storm, 34 degrees on the way. All right, Elliot, Heidi and James have stuck their hands up to ride with me here this morning. Have you guys done this before?
No.
Elliot? No. Okay, James?
No.
Heidi?
Yeah.
You have? Okay.
Yeah.
Any advice?
No.
Don't scream. Yeah, maybe number one. Oh, wow, she is, whoever that is. Oh, that's two boys. Awkward. That's probably going to be me in half an hour, guys. Hey, we've slip, slop, slap, seeked, and we're about to slide as well as we hang out with the Cancer Council and Australian Government this morning. We will see you with the tornado in half an hour.
You could do that all without the tube, Timmy. Thank you.